Time now for Gut Instinct. Our buddy Wayne Randazzo is doing his first BNNY. We're going to put him on
the
spot.
Check my gut here. Mm.
Yeah, there you go. All right, first one. Are the Mets crazy for letting Cespedes walk?
Well, he hasn't signed officially anywhere yet, so we don't know that he's walked for sure. But if he does end up signing somewhere else, and it does look like that, I mean, they have the reasons. It's a long-term deal. It's a lot of money. And it's a guy that really has bounced around throughout his career. I mean, he was in Detroit. He was in Oakland. He was in Boston. And he hasn't settled in one spot. So you have to wonder, you know, why hasn't he settled somewhere? Sure, those last 2 months were great. He helped this team get into the playoffs as much as anybody did. But moving forward, is he the kind of guy you want to risk being in a long-term deal and give $20 million a year to? I'm not sure the Mets think that that's the case when they have so much else they need to be worried about as far as their pitching, other spots in the order. There's only so much money to go around.
Yeah, I walked into the Mets clubhouse after maybe Cespedes had been on the team for a week. It was their first road trip, I believe. We were in Philadelphia, and I asked some people, like, how's it going with Cespedes? And the first guy I talked to was like, yeah, he's a prima donna, but he's good. So, I mean, literally, that was the answer. So how's that going to go over the course of the deal? I mean, we saw him have a few weird moments anyway. I mean, look, I'm not trying to kill the guy. I don't think he was a problem or anything. But he isn't someone who I would sign up for the next half decade or more for. Yeah. I'm sorry. It was a beautiful moment, and the Mets, I've said this before, I'll continue to say it, when he signed somewhere, they were smart to leave it at that beautiful moment.
You agree?
Yes, I do. I think it is a nice snapshot for the Mets, and we'll always have Cespedes, we'll always have those 2 months, you know, and a World Series run, but that's where it should end.
All right. Will the Nats signing Daniel Murphy come back to bite the Mets?
I think the Mets got a guy at second base right now that they believe in strongly, in Neil Walker. I mean, that was a big move for them. They're a very good defensive second baseman, guy who could swing the bat really well. So, to me, that kind of cancels out Murphy, and now a 3-year deal for Murph in Washington. The only thing is that you're going to see him 18 or 19 times in a season. They're your direct competition for the NL East. So will Dan Murphy have a case in those games against the Mets? The Mets played very well against Washington this past season. So will Dan Murphy have it in him to try to knock that off? Of course, I'm sure there will be something like that. But I think in the long term, they didn't really have a spot for Murphy anymore. They wanted to get a little more athletic up the middle, and they did by getting Neil Walker.
Yeah, just like when he was a player for the Mets, he may do the same thing as an opponent. He gives and he takes away.
Right. If the question is, will Daniel Murphy come back to bite the Nats? The answer, Doug, is yes. Many times in many goofy ways between second and third base and with a ball rolling between his legs. And other times, look, he is who he is. I do think that Murphy's a guy who tends to suffer when he overthinks things. Yeah. And one thing he might be overthinking is, I'd sure like to beat the Mets this year. So that might be something that bites him, I think.
Just for fun in the rivalry, I think he gets one game-winning hit against them, some sort of dagger, a double off of somebody in the seventh inning. And you know that. But as you say, he giveth and taketh away, and there will be some clanging off of his glove, too, I think, in Met games as well.
He's got plenty of games to choose from for that game-winning hit. All right, Matt Harvey, should the Mets trade him after this season?
I don't know that they should trade any of the pitchers until it comes down to the time where it's a free agency type situation and you have to make a determination if you're going to sign them or lose them for virtually nothing. They should, as they have, they should hang on to these starting pitchers for all they're worth. They got you to the World Series. You can find a bat somewhere to fill in a hole here and there if you need to, but these are the guys that are going to continue to carry you until the contracts start to come up, and obviously these guys are $800 or $900 million, maybe more combined, so you're not going to keep them all, but you should keep them until you can't keep them anymore.